Welcome to another episode of our Modern Warfare Easy Gold Camo Guide. This time, it's the SMGs. So the first episode, we already went over getting easy headshots. In this guide, we're going over all the other challenges for the SMGs. Link down below to the easy headshot guide. Please be sure to support the channel with a thumbs up and let's just get into it. So first up is the setup that I use, Streaks. Intel is everything, so you want to spam it using the personal radar and the UAV. You don't have to use them at the same time, kind of space them out. And remember, even if someone is running Ghost, they will still pop up when they fire their weapon. So for the final streak, something that isn't going to take you out of the game and distract you from your challenges. So if you want to get gold as soon as possible, you're not going to get it by driving around the Wally or flying around in a chopper gunner. That's taking you out of the game. And those minutes, they add up. That is taking you away from your focus of getting the gold camo. Once you get Damascus, once you get Platinum, whatever it is you want, you can focus on getting those high kill streaks. So Cluster Strike is really good, but I never win anything higher than the VTOL. VTOL is really good because you just set it and then forget it. Class setup. We already know the attachments really don't matter too much in this game, but what it is the perks. Cold-Blooded and Ghosts are the perks that are going to keep you alive. Keeping you alive, don't let you get distracted by streaks. They let you focus on the challenges you gotta work on. And this right here is a setup I use 90% of the time, with the exception for the smaller maps, high action maps. And for that, I'd run EOD instead of Cold-Blooded and Hardline instead of Ghost. Hardline, 2 kills, you get your personal UAV. You're probably not gonna live very long on the small maps. That's why I'd run it. Everything else is the same. And finally, the mode that I played most of the time was Hardcore Headquarters. It has lower health, fewer hit markers, and it has the fastest pace of all the hardcore modes. With the exception of Piccadilly, never play that map. And sometimes I'd back out of Grozna Raid. Thing is though, that map can be good for long shots. It depends on the lobby. Otherwise, it's a running simulator. And again, time is everything. I don't want to spend my time running around the map. It's all about small or mid-size. Another good playlist, if it's around, is like a Shoot House 24/7 or Rust 24/7, something with a small map playlist. Those can work too. All right, great. So we know the setup, we know the playlist that we want. Next is the challenges. First up is spray paint, get 500 kills. After that, it's woodland, get 100 headshots. Digital is get 110 kills while crouched. Moving on to Dragon, it is get 100 hipfire kills. Then it's Splinter, get 50 long shots, a lot less than the assault rifles. On to Topograph, get 50 kills while mounted. That's not too many. And then we have Tiger, get 250 kills with 5 attachments. On to Stripes, get 40 kills after a reload. Reptile, get 75 kills with no attachments. And then Skull, get 3 kills without dying 25 times. You complete all these challenges and you get the gold camo, which is under completionist. And as you can see on our MP7 variant, it actually looks pretty nice. You get every SMG gold and you get the platinum camo for the SMGs. And once you get every weapon in Modern Warfare Platinum, you unlock the final camo, Damascus. Now, some of these challenges, they are passive, meaning they will happen on their own. You don't really have to try for them. The passive challenges are spray paint, tiger, and skulls. Okay, they will just happen on their own. They're pretty easy. We're not going to worry about them. So that leaves us with 7 challenges to work on. And one of the fastest ways to get these challenges done is what I'm going to call the rollover method. What that means is, as soon as a new challenge becomes available, swap to it. Okay, you switch to that newest challenge and you make that challenge your primary focus. What this will do is, as you roll over to the newest challenge, you will then passively complete your previous challenges. And let me tell you, you would be surprised at how many headshots, long shots, reload kills you will complete even without even focusing on them. So with all that said, there are challenges that do complement each other. So if you can, you should take your newest challenge, whatever it is you're working on, and match it with something else that you can do at the same time. So for example, crouching and mounted kills, they go great together, crouching and mounted. But what about crouching plus mounted plus long shots? Very easy combo. Or crouching plus mounted plus headshots. Or even crouching, mounted, long shot, headshots. You see what I'm saying? Crouching, mounted, and no attachments. Really, those two, crouching and mounted, work great. And then you can put on whatever else you're working on. Crouching and mounted can be done at the same time as long as you crouch before you lean onto a surface. So speaking of mounting, even though there are tons of surfaces to lean onto, you can use the deployable cover to create mountable surfaces where they don't exist. So this is good for spaces where there is nothing to mount on, like the top of a structure, top of a building, a place with high traffic areas. But with that said, there are some maps that have plenty of walls, windows, all kinds of stuff to mount, so dead silence is a better option. So as I discussed in our previous guides, position yourself between the headquarters and enemy spawn so the enemy is funneled towards you. So either you can be between the headquarters and the enemy spawn, or you could put yourself in an overwatch type position where you're guarding the point while your team caps it. But you never want to rush the enemy spawn and flip it. Otherwise, that's the basic playstyle. I already went into detail with headquarters strategies in the two previous guides. Again, links to those down below. All right, so we know crouching and mounted kills work with other challenges. What else can we combine? So another two that work together are Dragon, get 100 hipfire kills, and Stripes, get 40 kills after reloading. For this, if a playlist with a small map like Shoot House is available, definitely do that. I did that for all my hipfire and reload kills. Fire a shot when you spawn in, or you could just reload when you think you're about to find someone. You know, the map is so small, you're just bound to bump into someone. And you got about 5 seconds, that's plenty of time in COD timing to find someone. The hipfire reloads is probably one of the more fun challenges. So all that really leaves us with is Reptile, get 75 kills with no attachments. But you can combine that with almost any other challenge in any mode that you like. But with no attachments, you know, hardcore kind of makes the most sense. No attachments and mounted, no attachments, crouching, you see what I'm saying? So in conclusion, the mentality you have to have going into this is always roll over to your newest challenge and how many challenges can you combine together. And once you're done with the newest challenge, then you work your way backwards, and what you'll find is how many headshots you got without even trying. It's way faster than just going for the headshots only and only the headshots at the start. Please support the channel with a thumbs up and leave a comment on what challenges you want a video on next. On the left side there is the Let's Play channel, and on the right, a brand new video.